Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about rounding numbers and odd and even numbers. Okay, so first of all you see rounding numbers. So rounding number means close to exact number. If any number is given to you, that one we have to round off to nearest number. Okay, so now rounding to the nearest 10. Okay, as you can see here I have drawn one number line. Okay, this is called number line. Here I have written 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay, so this is a tens number line. That means 2 tens, 3 tens, 4 tens, 5 tens and 6 tens. And there are small lines. So that one is like 20 to 30, in between 20 to 30, 21, 22, 23, 24 and so on. So first of all, I will show you by taking some example. So here the question is round off to nearest 10. Okay. So first one is given as 41. So we have to round off 41 to nearest 10. Okay. So now in number line, let us find where is 41. So it is 40 and the next dot will be 41, right? So the first step we have to see that 41 lies between which 10. So it is lies between 40 and 50. Okay. Now we have to see 41 is closer to which tens. Either it is closer to 4 tens or 5 tens. So by looking in this number line, it is very much clear that 41 is near to 40. Okay. So the answer will be 40. You can write the answer like this. 41 rounds down to 40. Okay, why I have written rounds down? Because it is decreasing. Okay, 41 and it is decreasing, so that is why it is 40. So that is why it is called round down. And if it could be 50, okay, then it could in place of down we should write up. Okay, so I'll show you how. So here you see 48. Okay, so now let's find out where is 48. So if it is 41, so 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48. Okay, so this point is 48, right? Now you see 48 is near to which tens, whether it is near to 4 tens or 5 tens. So it is also pretty much clear that it is nearby what? 50, right? So we will write that 48 rounds up to 50, okay? Because here 48 is nearer to 50. Okay, now the question is if it is in middle. Okay, that means 45. Okay, so 45 is this point. Okay, 45. So 45 is equal in this side also, it is nearer to 40, and in this case also it is nearer by 50. So how we will round off that? So in this case the rule is it will also round up. Okay, that means it will also go to 50. Okay, so you will write that 45 rounds up to 50. Okay, so the rules you will remember. Okay, so I have already pointed out things to remember. So you just you have to see if the ones place digit is 4 or less than 4, then round down. Okay, that means you need ones place means, so you know only at first we have already discussed about the place value. So here if the question is given as suppose 33, okay, so the ones place means what? 3. Now you see whether 3 is greater than 4 or not. So 3, we all know that 3 is less than 4. So obviously it will round down. Okay, round down, that means it will decrease. So 33 will be round down to what? 30. Okay, similarly if we take 92, okay, another example, this one 92. So you see 92, the unit place, that means ones place, is what? 2. 2 is in ones place, so obviously 2 is less than 4, so that is why it will also round down. And 92 is nearby what tens? Which tens? 90. Okay, now next rule is if ones digit is 5 or more than that, round up. Okay, so if it is given as suppose 75, okay, so you see in ones place it is 5, so obviously it will round up, so round up to 80. Suppose it is given as 59, okay, 59, so you see in ones place it is more than 5, so obviously it will also round up. So it is near to what? 60. Okay. Similarly, if another example is given, suppose 48. Okay, so 48, as we already have discussed, so 48 in unit in ones place it is 8, that is more than 5, so obviously it will round up, so round up to 50. If it could be 27, okay, suppose 27 is there. So, in unit place, it is what? In ones place, it is 7. So, obviously, again, it is more than 5. So, obviously, it will also round up to 30. So, these two things you remember. So, you can, by looking at the unit place, you can round off the numbers. Okay? Now, we will discuss about odd and even numbers. Okay? So, you see, I have written odd, even. Okay, odd number means what? The numbers that cannot be put into pairs are odd numbers. Okay, so that means the numbers which we cannot pair, okay, that is called odd numbers. So I have given some examples. See, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, etc. Okay, similarly, what is even number? All those numbers that can be put into pairs are called even numbers. Okay, that means the numbers which can be pair, so that one is called even numbers. So now example, you see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, so now you see I will show you. Suppose here I will take one, suppose this one, huh, one. Okay, so let's take one ball I have taken. So consider this one is a ball. So this ball can be paired up. There is no other ball. So, this is alone. So, that is why this one is called your odd numbers. Okay. Now, if I show you the even number. So, you see here this number I am considering 2. Okay. So, 2 ball I will draw. Okay. So, 2 ball. So, yes, they can be a pair. So, this is called one pair. Okay. So, 2 balls can be paired. Now, let's take 4. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have drawn 4 pair. Okay? Sorry, 4 balls. So, I can pair it by 2, 2. Yes, here it is 2 pair. Okay? So, see, these numbers can be paired up. So, that is why this is called what? Even numbers. But in case of odd number, we cannot pair them. So, here one ball cannot pair. Let's take 3. So, 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 ball I have taken. So, let's pair. So, 2 ball can pair. So, here it become 1 pair. And again, you see, 1 ball is left alone. So, that one is not, we cannot pair it. So, that is why 3 is also called as odd number. Okay, so from here you learn that the numbers which we can pair are called even numbers and which we cannot is called odd numbers. So here I have pointed out something, things to remember. Okay, so any number having odd numbers in their unit place or ones place are considered as odd numbers. Okay, so just now we learned what are odd numbers. So odd numbers such as I can show you, suppose 1, then 3, 5, 9, 7. Okay, so if these numbers are there in the ones place, then that number will be considered as odd number. Okay, so let's see. For example, we can show you suppose 21. Okay, so in place of in ones place it is 1, so 21 is a odd number. Okay, because in ones place 1 is there, so 1 is a odd number, so that is why 21 is also an odd number. Suppose 33. So, you see, in ones place, it is 3 and 3 is an odd number. So, that is why 33 is also an odd number. Okay. Suppose 57. So, in ones place, it is 7 and 7 is an odd number. So, that is why 57 is also an odd number. Okay. Now, you see, any number having even numbers such as 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 in their ones place are considered as even numbers. Okay. So that means Similarly, here in ones place, if it is odd number, then it will be considered as odd numbers, right? The whole number will become odd number. And if in ones place, if these even numbers are there, so that whole number will become even number. I will show you one example. Suppose 44. Okay, so in ones place 4 is there and 4 is a even number, so 44 will become a even number. Okay, now 10. Okay, 10. So in ones place 0 is there and 0 is a even number. Okay, so that is why it is called even. Okay, suppose we suppose another example, 26. Okay, so in ones place it is 6 and 6 is a even number, so 26, this whole number will become a even number. So always to tell you whether the number is odd number or even number, you have to focus on ones place. Okay, so if in ones place the number is odd, then the whole number will become odd number, and if it is even, then it will become even number. Okay, so I will give you some questions here, try to solve in your home. So these are your questions. Okay, round off to nearest 10. So 5 numbers I have given, you round off to nearest 10, and here write the even number from the following. So I have written some numbers here, so from here you have to find out the even numbers. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you, that as I told you that if in unit place 0 is there, then that number become even. Okay, but I told that 0 is even number, but 0 is neither a even number nor a odd number. Okay, because 0 means what? 0 means nothing. Okay, 0 means nothing, but when it is when 0 is alone, then it means nothing, but when it is with some numbers, then it means some value. Okay, so that means if it is with 10, means with 1, so 10 means 10. Okay, so 10 can be paired up. Okay, so with 10, suppose 10 ball if we consider, so there we can make 5 pairs. Okay, so that is why if 0 is included with some other number, then we can consider this whole number as even number. Okay, so just rectify that. 0 is not an even number, neither a odd number when it is alone. So because 0 means nothing, but when it is with some other number, so it is considered as a even number. Okay.